Hey, Elstrom.
Yeah.
I'm thirsty.
Well, so am I.
Oh, but there's nothing. Fred threw away his canteen.
Pick it up.
Why should I? It's empty.
You heard him, soldier. Pick it up.
I ain't no soldier, Sergeant.
If it'll hold water, we'll need it now. Pick it up.
You show me something to put in it, I'll go pick it up.
You heard the lieutenant, kid. Do as he says.
Oh, what the hell is this? You guys know the war is over. What's the matter with you anyway?
Get your hands off me.
Your hands are kind of long, kid. Next time I'll size them down.
There won't be a next time. All right, boys. We'll take a break over there.
I don't understand you, Fred.
Look, the war's over, and I don't like to be shoved around.
You agreed when we started out I'd ramrod this outfit.
It's still okay with me, but it's those other guys.
Still has to be a chain of command. No more Rebs to fight, but there's Indians. If we want to survive, we have to stick together.
Yes, sir.
Thought you said the war was over.
Okay, Larry.
Attaboy.
Hey, Elstrom.
What's the matter, kid? You lost your spunk?
Don't you worry about that. Tell me what we're doing here.
Well, let's see. We're riding across the dry and dusty plains of Oklahoma, a mighty band of the victorious Union Army. On our way to homestead land in exotic New Mexico, where we'll meet some pretty senoritas, marry them, settle down, and get rich. And live happily ever after.
Yeah, but what am I doing here?
Oh, you're a little crazy.
Well, sure, but you mean to tell me that you're really going to settle down and be a farmer?
Hell no, I'll have all you guys working for me inside a year.
No, no, not me, you won't. In fact, I think I might even turn around and go back right now.
You're not that crazy.
Why not?
Because you wouldn't get a mile before somebody imparted your hair.
All right, boys, there's wells at Fort Grant. We can fill our canteens there. Let's move out.
Well, maybe there's some whiskey there, too. Hey, McKay, much as I dislike you and your race, I hope if there's whiskey at Grant, it's Scotch whiskey.
Now, that's the first intelligent thing I've ever heard a puddle-headed Irishman say.
That can't be them. I don't see any woman with them.
It's those damn Yankees moving in. Seven. Eight. Nine, ten. Ten of them, sir.
10 Yankees, that's easy. McNamara, get me 20 men, Matt.
Hold it, McNamara.
We're gonna stop them, aren't we?
Not that way.
The minute the war's over, you're a Yankee lover.
I joined you because I thought you were still fighting for the Confederacy.
We are. But we have to be here when the caravan comes through, alive and not dead. And I'm in command. Any questions?
No.
All right then, McNamara, get the sentries posted. And get me a Yankee uniform. A captain's will do.
A Yankee uniform? What for?
I'm gonna wear it. And you get one too. From now on, this is Yankee POW camp. Remember, no trouble. You know what to do. And don't shoot to kill. Hold it!
This isn't Fort Hillway. You mind your manners around the brig, boys. We're just out of the U.S. 45th Cavalry, on our way to Santa Fe. All we want is food and water. I'm ex-Lieutenant Winton.
This ain't Santa Fe. Get on your way.
What do you mean, go on our way? You bring me your commanding officer, soldier, and I mean right now.
All we want is water.
He wants to see the captain.
Oh, I let one of them in.
Okay, Lieutenant, but just you.
You boys stay right here.
Hold it.
I want to talk with you.
There's nothing to talk about.
It's a matter of life or death.
You're wrong, friend. It's a matter of death only.
I don't understand you, Captain.
It's very simple. You and your men get out of here and get out of here fast.
Look, we're on our way to New Mexico.
I can't do anything to help you.
You're forgetting regulations, aren't you, Captain? This is government property, isn't it?
And you came here to remind me of regulations, huh?
Look, we've all done our bit, Captain. Discharged personnel are entitled to food and water. Now, that comes under the Homestead Act. You've heard of the Homestead Act, haven't you?
Look, Mr.
Winton. Larry Winton.
Mr. Winton, here's a proposition. I give you a canteen per man and a gallon per horse, and you get out of here right now.
That's practically nothing.
You heard my proposition, Mr. Winton. Now, my men will fire without warning. This is a POW camp. It's a matter of regulations, Mr. Winton.
Fire without warning. You hear?
All right. Make it fast. The men might get impatient.
I'm getting some water.
Where are you going? Hold it! Remember the lieutenant's orders. Stand fast! Crazy kid.
Oh, and Mr. Winton. The Indians own this territory. They don't want to share it with you.
If you'll take my advice, you won't waste a second.
Thank you, Captain.
Look, my men are really hungry. If you could give me 1 pound of bacon per man.
McNamara.
Yes, sir.
Give him a canteen per man and a gallon per horse, that's all.
Yes, sir.
I want you to know I just saved your life.
You wouldn't have to if you listened to orders.
Get away.
You know our mission, Mr. Bannister. We don't go after them.
They'll talk. If they're dead, they can't talk.
They won't talk. They'll run. They killed a Union soldier. They'll run long and far.
20 men in 1 hour.
We wait here for the wagons, Mr. Bannister. All of us. Zubari, sharp. Bring up the rear guard, but keep us in sight. Now we're in trouble. We gotta move fast.
It's that idiot kid. He killed a guard. Give him up.
We started together. We'll finish together. Now we gotta find water. The army's behind us, and we're in Indian country, so keep your eyes open. All right, come up here and get these canteens. Now take it easy on the water. It may have to last us a while.
Guess I kind of messed up back there, huh?
Yeah.
What's the matter? What's on your mind?
You know, there's something funny about that Fort Grant. I always get a good look at a man when he's trying to kill me.
Not me. I'm always too busy.
Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked to me like three of those soldiers trying to gun me down was wearing Reb uniforms. Get!
Popped off, Larry. You know how bad I want to get started again. I ain't no soldier, I'm a farmer. Santa Fe means I can live again. No more killing. I don't want anything to stop us.
It's all right, Slim, you forget it. Straight ahead seems like there's a town over there. Let's move out. Thank you.
three wagons in the carriage at Paramo Point.
A carriage?
Shall we get ready to go, sir?
Well, the wagons are important, but...
But what?
She's more important. McNamara, send this message. Have Delmer and Forrester check if Violet Belmont is with the caravan. Send it right away.
Yes, sir. How do you know we can use it?
Well, whoever lived here didn't die from water poisoning.
I don't like this place.
What's the matter? Just because the saloon is closed?
I don't like it either. Let's camp outside.
No, here. I don't want anyone to see a fire.
No one was following. I was watching.
Maybe not, but if Peck could listen once in a while, we wouldn't be outlaws.
I don't think we're outlaws. We'll talk about that later, but tonight we're going to stay here. We'll water the horses and put them in the blacksmith shop. Zabari, you, Meyer, and Sharp take care of the horses. The rest of us will look around.
Forget it. You ain't in a hurry anymore.
The horses have the treasure.
Treasure of various types.
You know him, ma'am?
Let's put it this way. He knows me, Sergeant Benham.
Sergeant Delmar, ma'am.
Can you possibly come with us?
I'm sorry, Miss Velmont. It's impossible. I've been given strict orders. Besides, there are friends waiting for you at Fort Grant.
Thank you, Sergeant Delmer. I'm glad to know that the horses have the treasure. I'll see you soon.
Goodbye. I'll inform Fort Grant that spring is here.
You know what you have to say. Good luck, Sergeant. Let's continue, Sergeant Benham.
Goodbye.
Wagons are on that way, she must be with them. What about the prisoners?
We'll see about them later.
But when? You can't wait till the last minute to shoot them.
It seems as if you like the idea.
This is war.
The war is over.
Torn up. Somebody was looking for something. Something that was valuable. But why way out here in a little deserted town in the middle of nowhere?
Well, whatever it was, it sure don't look like they found it. Hey, maybe the troops got here ahead of us and were looking for the kid.
Leave him alone.
Sure, he's my buddy. Besides, someday he's gonna be my top hand.
You know, those guys got what they deserved. They had no right to refuse us water. We fought in a war just like them.
Yeah. But I wonder which side they fought on. Sure didn't seem to be ours.
There's something strange about this town. Fort Grant, too. Can't figure it out. Fred Hillstrom, let's go check the horses.
Good morning, Major Benton. I'm sorry to interrupt your sleep, but we have to leave now. I want you to understand, Major, you and your men, that I'm trying to save your lives.
That's very kind of you, Major Hyde.
We'll travel together until I've decided to let you go.
You're mistaken. When you and your men took over this fort, the war was over. You're not soldiers any longer, just outlaws and bandits.
If you'll come with us, Major, you'll save your lives. All I want is your word of honor.
Wrong again. My men and I will escape at the first opportunity.
I am not in a position to appreciate your courage. I am sorry. Think it over, Major. I'll see you later. Welcome to Fort Grant, Miss Belmont.
Why?
Because we waited for you for a long time. And because you're more beautiful than we expected.
Are you Adam Hyde? One of your men gave me the password a few miles from here. I thought you were ready to depart.
We are, but I'm sure you and your men need a rest.
You're wrong, Major. What I need is to end all this as soon as possible.
All right, we leave in 2 hours' time.
The Indians are around. We've seen them...
I don't think a 2-hour wait will keep them from attacking if that's what they have in mind.
Hey, Larry.
What?
This is funny.
What is?
It's Forge.
This is a blacksmith shop, isn't it?
Yeah, but this is a jeweler's forge. They use those for precious metals.
Maybe this blacksmith had a hobby. Come on, Fred, let's check the horses. One time.
Awful small horses. These wouldn't fit any of ours. What the hell are you doing?
That snake had a dead aim right on your leg.
Thanks.
What's going on here?
Nothing, just wanted to see if you're awake.
Oh, funny.
Hey, Larry. Where'd you get a gold bullet?
That's good northern lead.
That's gold.
I'm sure it looks like gold.
Where'd that ricochet from? Billstrom, let me have your knife.
Gold.
Yeah, it's gold.
Where's the gold?
Lieutenant Bannister, my father was killed for keeping that secret.
Forget that question, Miss Belmont.
Just remember the answer. We're just complying with your own order to take the gold to Mexico.
It's part of the Confederate treasury and belongs to its legitimate owners. My father was a banker, an honest man. He promised to deliver it, and it will be done.
I don't think Lieutenant Bannister meant any doubts against Charles Belmont's honesty.
I hope not, Major.
But I don't think it's very advisable that only one person should know the secret of the whereabouts of such a big fortune, a real treasure. If something should happen to you, Miss Belmont, that's a lot of money.
If I got killed, for example?
For example.
You can be sure, Lieutenant, that my father considered such a possibility.
Bannister, get ready to leave in 10 minutes.
Yes, Major. Yes, sir. I'm leaving. See you later, Miss Belmont.
Major Hyde, do you believe we'll make it to Mexico?
We'll try hard. My intentions are absolutely honest.
What about the rest of them here?
I can't guarantee a thing.
In case of an emergency, who can we trust?
No one in the case of a real emergency.
I don't mean the Indians.
I know what you mean.
Just enough of them, they're all gold. couple $1 million worth. Split 10 ways, that makes about...
Think of the whiskey we can buy.
And even split, we're all rich.
I'll make me gold bugle.
That's not what we're going to do with it.
All right, Larry. What are we going to do with it?
We take that gold, we're the same as thieves. We turn it over to the government, we'll get our fair share of it. How much, I don't know, but certainly enough for a fresh start. That gold is nothing but trouble and lots of it.
Silly to give it up.
I say we take it.
How?
Oh, I hate to do this, but I agree with the Scot. We load the horses and take it out.
How much do you think a horse can carry, the man riding them?
We could take it, would be safe to carry.
How many of you want to leave most of it here?
I have to trust someone. Do you know a place called Southernville?
I know the place.
The gold is there.
No, it isn't. We searched every square inch of it. Someone must have gotten there first.
I say we go back to Fort Grant, try and square ourselves and collect a finder's fee.
I agree with Laddie.
Me too.
I'm sorry, Larry. I ain't going back to Fort Grant to get hung. And I want my share.
Well, I guess you're waiting for my answer. Okay, Larry.
All of you are with me. Let's get outside. I'll give you a little chance to think it over. If you don't agree with me, we'll be outside with our fingers on the trigger.
$1 million in Confederate bills?
No currency. Gold.
For that,
I'd risk 5 lives.
Fighting who?
First, the Indian.
And second?
Second, you'll have to fight to get the $1 million.
You mean everybody?
Almost.
Where is the million?
For the time being, only she knows.
Okay. You want to know why wagons come empty.
I'm not empty. Water.
Indian, no.
Horses work harder with full load. Why gray whites and blue whites fight at Fort? Why white woman come in crazy carriage?
Hell no.
Me want no. You tongue. Not dry enough.
All right, now what?
Oh, we pick them off or drive them off. I don't care which. Then we build Indian sleds and haul this stuff out of here.
Well, yeah, but we're boxed in here.
I know, kid. But we got the gold.
What do we do now, boss?
Nothing. They can't get out unless we let them.
Let them out? Why?
We've been together a long time. I don't want to kill them. If they want to ride empty-handed, I'll let them go.
Belmont Bank? Hey, could that be Charles Belmont, the bank from New Orleans? They say Charles Belmont was a great man, extraordinarily rich. He loved arts and good food, and most important of all, he was an honest man.
Then Belmont was not only great, he was unique.
Charles Belmont. The man who moved his bank to escape the war. Well, I guess Southernville clears up a lot of things now.
Nobody would believe this, spending all night in the bank, watching $2 million that some crazy banker kept in the blacksmith shop.
I don't think he was so crazy.
No, just loco.
No. If he'd have hidden it any place else, he would have found it. You saw how they searched this town. They looked every place, except right under their noses.
DeBerry! Yo!
What's the matter, Scott? You're lonely?
No, but when I'm watching the front door, I like to make sure someone else is watching the bank.
When do we move out of here, Lieutenant?
We can't. They've got the horses and we can't walk to Fort Grant.
And we never make it. Look. What the hell are they telling each other?
You may get scalped before you find out. Hey, Hillstrom! I want to talk to you. Hillstrom! I got to talk to you. It's important.
You do the talking, I'll listen.
What do you want?
You got a window on the north side?
Yeah, so what?
Well, take a look outside.
What do you see, Mayor?
Smoke signals. Lots of them.
Well, that must be it. Indians! We know, so what?
Our only chance is Fort Grant, with the gold or without it.
Not there, you hear me? Not there, not Fort Grant!
Get out of here.
When grown-ups talk, kids shut up.
All right, go ahead. Here's a grown-up to talk to. If you don't want to stay, why don't you get the hell out?
Because you've got the horses.
I know we've got the horses. You can walk.
Don't be a damn fool, Hillstrom. You can't buy your lives with that gold.
Get out of here.
Hold it, Slim. Go back to your place. Ain't nobody going anywhere.
I'd rather take an arrow than a damn rope.
That's your problem, boy. Let's use some common sense while there's still some left around here. Hey, Larry! You hear me?
I hear you.
We've decided you're the boss.
That's better.
And if anyone don't agree, he can move now and fast.
All right, if you want to save your hide, you better ride for Fort Grant before the Indians burn this place up. What are you waiting for?
I ain't waiting for nothing, Larry. I'm going the other way.
Are you crazy, Fred?
I gotta go the other way, Larry.
I understand the kid. I'm not gonna let him go by himself.
Good luck, Fred.
But I want them to see.
You what?
You want to get to Santa Fe alive, don't you?
What's wrong with
it? Well, relax, boy. You listen to me, follow my advice, and you'll get there alive. And rich. Oh.
let him lie there? Shut up, kid. Don't move and let me do the talking.
Tie him down. Just a minute, Chief. I want to talk to you.
Talk later.
Look, I'm your prisoner because I wanted to be. I got a proposition for you. I can make you the biggest Indian chief of all the chiefs.
Numitai now biggest of all Indian chiefs. Numitai no need help from jackals.
Yeah, but you can't win with bows and arrows. I can offer you guns, rifles, ammunition, even cannon.
Talk.
I can offer you $1 million in gold.
You said guns.
Gold buys guns.
Who sell me guns?
Me? I know where I can get guns.
Why you do this? You like Indian?
Well, I like money. For one half of the gold, one wagon, and safe passage, I'll lead you to the gold. You get the rest. Then when I bring you the guns, you pay me the rest of the gold.
How I know you come back?
Because I'm a thief. I couldn't resist that much gold.
Wait, we talk more.
You should have been a lawyer.
Wagon train. Many wagons leave Fort with gray whites and blue whites. Maybe come here tomorrow. Wagon's empty.
Wagon's empty? Well, that's it. Somebody ought to be coming for it.
White man, you talk me.
Sure, Chief. It'll be easy. We'll let them load the gold, then we take the wagons.
I take wagon.
That's what I said. We're partners. Now, one or two of those wagons will be riding heavy. They'll be carrying ammunition. Cut them out and take them before they get to... Where, I'll tell you later.
Paleface clever. We do it.
Anyone ever tell you never trust an Indian?
Just you worry whether anyone ever told us Indians never to trust a jackal.
What about him?
Indian no need prisoner more.
Let's get out of here!
can. Go easy on that ammunition. We may be here a spell.
I feel like I'm trapped in a bank vault.
What a way for a Scotsman to die.
Engines.
No, it isn't. Those horses are shot. Come on.
Drop your gun.
Bannister, how many times do I have to tell you I'll give the orders? All right, throw them away. You'll be treated fairly.
I remember your fair treatment back at the fort. All right, men, do as he says.
Who are they?
Renegades. They killed a couple of our men back at the fort.
How long have they been here?
A couple of days, I guess.
Why'd you stay here?
I don't believe we've met.
Miss Velmont, Lieutenant Winton.
Velmont. Well, I think you know why we're here.
The blacksmith shop, quickly. The horseshoes,
they're
both.
All right. Throw them in the saloon with the rest of the prisoners.
Lieutenant Larry Winton, United States Army, sir.
Major Benton, United States Army?
Active. Who are they?
Those? They're a bunch of renegade rebs. I gather they're here for a cache of Confederate gold. They're a bad lot. If it weren't for Hyde, we'd have all been dead long ago.
Well, you still may be, Major. There's a couple of million dollars worth of gold in that cache.
Get the wagons ready, Bannister.
It's over, Adam. Let me have your gun.
You'll get shot for this, Ed.
Maybe so, Adam. But they'll have to find me first.
But the gold belongs to the Confederacy.
What Confederacy? We're through fighting for a lost cause. That treasure is ours. We are now the Confederacy. Excuse me, ma'am. Lock them up with the others. They'll enjoy their company.
I warn you, Ed, you won't get away with it.
You gonna stop me, Adam?
Miss Belmont, si no le importara unirse a nosotros, estoy dispuesto a repartir con usted. ¿Quiere acompañarnos? Resultaría todo mucho más legal. Y además de socios, podríamos ser amigos.
Mr.
What are you going to do with all that gold now, Miss Belmont?
Shut up, Win.
Okay, Reb. I guess us Yanks fight a little different than you Southern gentlemen.
I said shut up.
Sun almost gone. Indian like fight better in daytime.
Well, all we have to do is bottle them up for the night and finish them tomorrow.
What about fire machine?
I can capture their ammunition now. Might be a good idea to get those wagons.
Todo cargado.
What I call a cavalry raid. Beautiful. And they left the other wagons intact.
I don't like it. They might be killing some of our friends.
Forget it, kid. We don't have any friends. Well done, Chief.
The ammunition wagons.
We've got the gold. Let's go.
You're crazy, the thousands of them.
They'll be busy with those wagons for a couple of hours. We got a head start.
What about the Indians?
The Indians can have them. Let's go.
Johnson, give me that gun.
Look out, Major. I don't want to have to kill you.
Johnson, give me that gun. I'm still your commanding officer. Bannister! Hold it right there, Bannister. Don't move. Benham! You and your men get back to your posts. If I don't get you, those Indians will.
Yes, sir.
Wait!
Linton. I'll make you a proposition. Give me your word you won't fight us in this town until the Indians are taken care of, and I'll turn you loose and arm you.
You want us to help you save your gold?
I mean to help save your lives. And after the battle, we start from scratch.
It's a deal.
Good.
I don't need that. I gave you my word.
How about you?
I agree.
Good.
Johnson!
Sir?
Arm these men and turn them loose. McNamara, come on.
Lieutenant Winton. May I speak with you for a moment?
Yes, ma'am.
Is there any way I can induce you to help us to get the gold to Mexico when this is over?
No, ma'am.
But it was my father's gold.
It's Confederate gold, and it's going to Confederates in Mexico.
That was what my father wanted.
A lot of people in the war wanted a lot of things that they didn't get.
Isn't there any agreement we can reach?
Yes, there is. Grant and Lee reached it. The war is over. Now we can live together like decent people. So give up your Confederacy, Miss Velmont, and give up your gold. 6 months ago, I couldn't have talked to you like this because you're a Southerner, and I'm a Yankee. But today, you can talk to anyone in the country because we're all Americans again. You think that over, Miss Velmont.
Just wanted to see what we've got, Chief.
We have nothing. I have wagons.
I thought we were partners.
Numata no have partners, white man. Only Indians. You my prisoner till I tell go.
Don't push him so much, you damn fool.
We're doing all right so far, aren't we?
Yeah, that's why I didn't sleep last night.
Go on, wagon. Look, see if right.
The damn fools, where's the powder?
Plenty of shells, there's no powder.
Your braves are fools. They forgot the powder.
Keep quiet, thief, or you die now. White thief made big mistake. Yes?
No mistake, Chief. It's all right. I got the powder, but no shells. We can still take them easy once they get the wagons loaded.
You talk smooth, like Riverstone. We wait and see.
Well, why don't we attack now, before they get ready for us?
Day grows old. Indian sleep night. Attack first light. I think you wait for me. Yes?
Oh. Well, I don't know how much good this is going to do.
You got a better idea?
Sure, but I don't think it'll work. Instead of waiting for them, we attack.
Oh, that's a bright idea. There must be about a million of them out there.
Well, you've got a great equalizer right here.
That's just to scare them. We got plenty of powder and no shot. When they come back in, we fire blanks.
Well, there must be a lot of iron in this town.
Oh, well, tell me how to melt it down and make shells.
You work for Velmont. I'll see her.
What for? You haven't got any tea.
Come on. How much is that gold worth to you, ma'am?
The gold goes where I go.
Would you give it to save your life?
Only then, if I had to.
I have an idea. It might take all night. We'll melt that gold down into shells and fill them with powder. He's right, man. I'm sorry.
¿Qué le pasa a Mackay?
Que es escocés, y un escocés no puede soportar que arrojen el oro a los indios.
Tiene razón. Yo también voy a llorar con él.
All right, I'll take care of that in the town.
I'll cover this end.
Okay, I'll take care of the cannon.
Nothing yet? Okay, keep alert. Seen anything, Scotty?
No. Doesn't look like there's an Indian within 100 miles.
Don't you bet on it.
Machine shoot. Kill Indian.
Oh, we can still beat them. Just don't circle them or charge direct. Attack them from their flanks. And, there are ways of protecting your braves from their rifles.
Speak.
Oh, the cannon won't do any good here. They're too spread out.
Over there! Come on, let's go!
Reverse the gun. Come on, let's go.
Fuego!
again. Indian attack like you say, but lose. Now we fight my way. We circle and kill like Indian.
That town, it's as dry as a tinderbox. Now if we can set fire to it, we can burn them out.
White man talk brave, but want to see Indian die fighting.
No, Chief. You give us back our guns and we'll fight with you. I'll even set the fire myself.
You can have guns back. But this time, if you lie, Indian kill you.
No, Hillstrom, you can't do that.
No way out now, kid.
Seem to get used to shooting at naked people. It's like pulling a gun on a man in his bathtub.
Faith, you people fight in pinafores.
I've told you 100 times it's a kilt.
Tell me once again. Quit saving bullets, man. This is certainly no time to be thrifty. I don't suppose I'd ever have told you, but I've always thought of you. That's the best friend I ever had.
Aim it at that building. We'll put that fire out.
Bueno, mayor. Mis hombres y yo hemos cumplido nuestro compromiso. No, todavía no. Volverán.
Claro que sí, volverán y volverán mientras no se acaben todas las tribus de América.
¿Qué quiere usted que hagamos? ¿Correr por todo el país detrás de ellos?
¿Por qué no?
Uno de los principios de la guerra, señor capitán, es destruir las bases de aprovisionamiento del enemigo.
Muy bien.
¿Y si su campamento está 5 millas de aquí, cree usted que llegaría con este cañón?
No he querido decir eso.
¡No disparen! ¡Soy yo! ¡No disparen!
¿De dónde vienes, Fred? Creo que me debes una explicación.
Sí, ya lo sé, luego. Ahora vienen los indios por la colina.
¿A qué estáis esperando? ¡El cañón al otro lado de la calle! ¡Vamos, moveos, rápido!
¡Están detrás de aquella roca!
Well, it looks like we cut them down to size.
We sure did. You did with those expensive cannonballs. Shake hands?
Sure.
Yankee gold after all.
It's nobody's gold, Reb.
I didn't get to know him very well. But he was the last of a dying breed of Southerners.
Perhaps. I think there are a lot of them left. Both in the North and in the South. We'll be on our way. Now, Numitar's dead. Most of the big drives around here are broken up.
I don't think we'll run into anything we can't handle. Well, ma'am, I hope you like Santa Fe.
So do I. What are you going to do with Fred?
He wants to rejoin the army. Is he any good?
Oh, he's kind of crazy, but one of the best. Shall we move?
I guess this is better than the carriage for this kind of travel.
Well, it's all yours, Major. All you have to do is dig it up.
We'll go to work on it.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Hey, Larry. I'll see you in Santa Fe after my hitch is up. We'll be waiting for you.